Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. In the 1930s, the WPA employed millions of unemployed people in the United States to carry out public work projects. Artists were hired to design posters to announce or remind people about jobs, health issues, travel, and even art exhibitions. I created this one as an example of a WPA-style poster and will show you how to recreate it. I provided this silhouette of a gear so you can download it and use it for your poster. Its link is located in the video's description or project files. Make a new document by going to File and New. We'll name it WPA Poster. The size of this document is 1280 by 864 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. For now, let's make the background black. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, click on the small overlapping box icon. To fill your background with the foreground color, press Alt-Delete on a PC or Option-Delete on a Mac. Open your horizontal type tool and choose an Art Deco style font. I'm using American Captain, which I provided that link as well. Make the size 50 points, sharp, left alignment, and click on the color box. For the color, type in C10D0C. Click OK or press Enter or Return. Click on the lower left of your document and type your bottom line of text. Reduce the fill to 0%. Your text will look like it disappeared, but it's still there. Click on the FX button and choose Stroke. Click on the color box and type in F8D2A5, then press Enter or Return. Make the size 3 pixels, the position outside, the blend mode normal, and the opacity 100%. Then press Enter or Return. Go to View and make sure Snap is not checked. If it is, simply click on it. To enlarge and position your text so it's flush with both sides of your document, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Click on your text and move it to the lower left so the left edge of your text is flush with the left edge of your document. Go to the top right corner of your Transform, and when you see a straight double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it out until the right edge of your text is flush with the right edge of your document. To slide the text down, press the down arrow on your keyboard until the bottom of your text is flush with the bottom of your document. When your text is flush with the sides and bottom, press Enter or Return. Make a copy of the text layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press and hold Shift and drag the text straight up near the top. Open the Transform tool, go to the top right corner, and reduce its size. Press T to open your Type tool, highlight the entire line, and type out new text. Click on your Move tool, open your Transform again, and move it up and flush with the left edge of your document. Enlarge its size until it's flush with the right edge of your document. Slide the text to the top by pressing your up arrow key on your keyboard. Then press Enter or Return. We need to make a copy of the two layers of text. To do this, shift-click on the bottom text to highlight it and press Ctrl or Command J. Click off the eyeballs of the effects on the top two layers and bring the fill back to 100%. We'll place these two layers into its own folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. We'll name it Text Inside since they're the inside colors of the text. We'll group the original text layers into their own folder as well. Make the top open layer active, and shift-click on the bottom text layer. Press Ctrl or Command G, and we'll name this folder Text Border, since these layers are the border outlines. Drag the border folder to the top and make the background active. We'll fill it with the color of the border. Press I on your keyboard to open the eyedropper tool. Click on the border to pick up its color. Now, the foreground color is the same as the border. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the background with the foreground color. Open the gear file I provided. To get it into your poster document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it up onto the tab of the poster. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and then release. To reduce its size, open your Transform tool and click on the chain link between the width and the height. This ensures that the width and the height will have the same percentage in each. For this example, type in 45.75% in either the width or the height. Notice they both have the same percentage. Drag the transform to a position and press Enter or Return. Drag the gear layer between the two text layers. Change the blend mode to soft light. Double-click on the gear thumbnail to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay and make the angle 0 degrees. Make the blend mode multiply and click on the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Make sure the black to white gradient is chosen. Click OK on both windows to accept them. Make a copy of the layer and press V to open your Move tool. Drag the copy of the gear over so its teeth interconnect with the original gear. Let's reverse the gradient of this gear. Double-click on the gradient overlay of the copy and check Reverse. Then click OK. Next, we'll make a border surrounding the inside edge of the document. Make the top layer active and click on the New Layer button to make a new layer. Press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill it with the background color. It really doesn't matter what color you fill it with since we're reducing the fill to 0%. Click on the FX button and choose Stroke. Click on the color box and click down on your background to pick up its color. Click OK on the color picker window and change the position to inside. Make sure the size is the same as the size of the border of your text. The last step is to add a paper texture to the poster. Make a composite snapshot of this image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on a PC or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and choose Texturizer. Make the texture sandstone, the scaling 100%, the relief 5, and the light from the top. If your document has a different size and resolution, you may want to adjust these numbers. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.